all over this room. If you can, if you feel comfortable, can you lift your hands in this moment?
Hallelujah.
And just begin to release a sound to the Lord all over this room. Come on, if you have a worship on your lips, come on, if you can release it right now. Only you can speak to the goodness of God in your life. Only you can speak and testify of the goodness of Jesus. So in this moment, I just want you to release a thank you in this atmosphere. Sounds of the Lord.
It's
Come on, lift it up tonight, church. Say, come on, just the voices. Let us become. Your desire tonight, come on, why don't you just let the Lord know that you would want more of His presence, more of His power, more of His Spirit. Hallelujah. Those hands all over this room as we call on the Lord. Come on, let's sing it together right here. Christ is my firm.
Christ is my firm foundation. He's the rock on which I stand.
When everything around me is shaking,
I've never been more glad. I'll put I'm
tonight. Come on, pull on your neighbor and say, he won't fail. Look at somebody else and say, he never has and he never will. Somebody shout and give God praise in the room.
I wanna hear voices of angels.
To be praised. Our God is great and greatly to be praised. So let me set our expectation for this evening. We have created an environment to where God can visit us. He's here. He's already set up the table. It's our job to pull up. So what I mean by that is we don't want to come into the house of God, see God here, and not partake of what he's here to do. So we have a myriad of things in this room. We have some on the brink of divorce, some on the brink of depression, some that's just in a great season and just want to thank God for the season that they're in. Some are just still trying to find their way. But we want you to feel liberty to come to the altar when Josue is leading in worship. We just want you to be free. We want you to connect with God. We don't want you to say you went to a concert, but we want you to say you went to an encounter with God. So I want to take a moment and just begin to pray for whatever you may have brought here with you. But let's just be 100. Everybody has brought something in this room, right? Somebody drove here. They never spoke to their spouse on the way here. Somebody may got a few more days until foreclosure. Somebody may have an illness in their body that they need God to meet. Like, I don't know what it is. Some just are just tired, right? But this is the moment to give to God what you've been carrying. Because we can oftentimes carry things longer than God wants, okay? And so this is our opportunity to do that. So I want to pray for us in this atmosphere and those that are even online, that you will accept the invitation to be naked before God, who you shouldn't be ashamed of. So Father, in the name of Jesus, we know that you are here. We know that you are present. You are a present help in the time of trouble. So God, we ask that the brother and the sister who stands to the left and to my right, that you would visit them in the way that they need, that they would not be able to leave here and say they did not feel God, that they will be able to say that they stepped into an environment where God was and they met God in a special way. So Father, I pray you reprogram minds, you deprogram minds. I pray, Holy Spirit, that you guide hearts, that eyes are open, that they may see in a different way that they've never seen before, that ears will open up and hear things that they may have needed to hear, but they did not hear. And Father, I speak strength to the person that needs it in the name of Jesus, that God, you would not just give them physical strength, you would give them emotional strength, that God, they would know that you are here with them in the name of Jesus. So Holy Spirit, have your way. We are open to you to have your way. We remove our limitations, our restrictions, the frailties of our bodies, and we say, Lord, move in this sacred space. We didn't come on a Wednesday night just to hear another song being sung, but God, give us a song that touches our heart in a way that we've never seen before. Open up our ears, our eyes, our understanding to have a deeper capacity of who you are. Take us to a dimension with you that we've never been before. That God, we will leave this place saying, I met Elohim, I met El Shaddai, I met Jehovah Jireh, the Lord that provides. And God, even if the situation doesn't change, we met a God that can change all situations and all circumstances. So God, we give you this atmosphere and we say, God, do what only you can do. Speak to the hearts of your children. We ask you, God, that you'll give them rest from the labors and the toils that they go through. But God, we ask you to do what only you can do. You show yourself strong and mighty. Mighty are you. Mighty are you in battle. And so, Lord, even in chaos, we know you are still God and you are still Lord. And so we give you our hearts, our lives, our minds, our souls, our bodies. And we say, Jehovah Jireh, have your way. Yahweh, do what only you can do. Move as only you can move. So we lay addictions at your feet. We lay addictions at your feet tonight. We lay addictions at your feet tonight. We lay sorrow at your feet tonight. We lay sorrow at your feet tonight. Sadness, we lay it at your feet tonight. Weeping indoors for the night, and we give you the night. 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 We give you our sorrow. We give you our weeping. We believe that joy is our portion, and you are here to give joy and joy more abundantly. And so we receive. We receive. We receive. We open our hearts to receive. In the matchless and the mighty name of Jesus. Now, can you send the praise as a seed of expectation? Come on, can you use your praise as a seed of expectation? This place. Come on, lift up your voice to the Father. For he is good and he is worthy. He's worthy to be praised. Altar is going to be open. We're going to shift some things. We're going to do our giving at the end. We'll run our video announcements at the end. So this was going to last 45 minutes or so, 30, 45 minutes, and just worship. No formulas, no big eyes, no little use. Come into the presence of God and get everything you need. The buffet is spread. Just receive. So I don't know if they have an intro video. Yeah or nay, I can't see. No. Yay. Okay. being said, I want us to, this is his first time being here with us. He's a worshiper. He's a gift that God is going to use tonight as a fountain to pour into our cups. Let's be ready to receive. It's not about my favorite song. It's about bring me into the presence that I might find the peace of God. I want you to clap it up and welcome Josue Avila as he comes.
He is worthy of all the glory and all the honor and praise. Everything that is done in this room is to lift him up. All the credit and all of the recognition belongs to Jesus Christ today. Why don't you just take a moment and lift up your hands and say, Jesus, have your way in this place. Have your way, Jesus. Sing this all together.
And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to do whatever you want to.
Say, I will make room.
And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to do whatever you.
Sing this all together. Here is where I lay it down.
Here is where I lay it down.
Every burden and every crown. This is my surrender.
This is my surrender.
This is my surrender.
This is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down. Every lie and every doubt. This is my surrender.
Come on and lift up. Say, I will make room,
and I will make room for you
to do whatever you want,
to do whatever you want,
oh,
to do whatever you want.
I will make room,
I will make room for you to do whatever you want.
Oh, Holy Spirit, have your way. Lift up your hands and say, Jesus, have your way. Holy Spirit, have your way.
Say what you want to say. Move the way you want to move. Oh, Holy Spirit.
You're all Everybody sing in one voice and I'll never know. Come on and worship the Lord in this place. Come on and worship Him, worship Him. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, here we are, Jesus. Here we are, God. If there's one thing that I absolutely adore about Jesus is His love. There's something so amazing and so powerful when I feel His love, when I hear about it, when I learn about it, and when He embraces you with His love, it's just something that is life-changing. And I can sometimes be discouraged, I can sometimes be tired, I can sometimes not feel like worshiping, but when I think about His love, when I think about His love, all of those things that get in the way of my worship just start to disappear. All of those things, even my own self, even me being tired, I suddenly have a little bit more strength to shout. I suddenly have a little bit more strength to lift up my hands. I suddenly have a little bit more strength to sing and just to dance a little bit and celebrate that I am loved. Even
though I don't deserve it, I am so grateful. I am so happy and so grateful that he loves me in spite of my mess, that he loves me in spite of all the negative. He loves me the way I don't know how to love. He loves me no matter what, and there's nothing that I can do about it. So I want you to look at somebody next to you and say, he loves you, and there's nothing you can do about it. I think somebody needs to celebrate that just a little bit, because I think we can give God lots of reasons for him not to love us. But I'm so thankful for grace. I'm thankful for grace. Anybody in this room thankful for the grace of God? Hallelujah. Somebody clap with us today. Hey. We're gonna sing with all of our hearts. We're gonna celebrate him. And it sounds like this. Say, all around, everywhere I look, your love is all around. All around, all around, everywhere I look, your love is all around. Everybody say, all around.
Time after time after time, 'cause your love lifted me. It's too deep to navigate, and it's too high to climb. Oh, but still, still it's available. Time after time, after time, after time, after time. Somebody say yeah.
look, your love is all around. Everywhere I look, your love is all around.
Say, everywhere I look, your love is all around. Everywhere I look, your love is all around. Everywhere I look, your love is all around. Everywhere I look, your love is
all around.
I could sing about his love forever and ever and ever until my voice just is gone. And you know what I love about doing this is that this is, we're practicing what we're doing in heaven. We're practicing. So if you're getting tired, it's all good. You know, I know you had a hard day of work, but let me tell you, when we get to heaven, there's no stopping. There's no stopping. So you need to get used to this. Look at somebody and say, get used to this. Tell somebody else, hey, you better get used to this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's nothing better than to be in the house of God, in the presence of God. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. All right. All right, come on, behave now. There we go. You know, I need to ask this question because we're gonna get back into worship, Pastor. But there's one thing that I love to do. I've been to many places where I have learned different styles of worship. One of my most amazing experiences in worship was when I was in Africa. And that's why I love to put a little bit of sazon in the music, a little bit of, you know, I love that stuff. But one thing that I also need to give credit to is my Latino family. It's funny, a lot of people assume that I'm Puerto Rican. I'm not Puerto Rican. My wife is Puerto Rican, but I grew up in a place where there was no Puerto Ricans, believe it or not. Well, I'm probably exaggerating, but I didn't know much about their culture or anything until I moved from Texas to Connecticut. And you from Connecticut? Oh, we gotta talk, sister. So Puerto Ricans all over the place in Connecticut. And then I learned something that lots of Puerto Ricans sing in their churches, and it's called coritos. You guys know what coritos are? It's like the typical songs that every church in the whole world sings with the same rhythm and everything. And I'm like, wow, that is pretty cool. So I started learning a little bit of coritos. And I know this is a song that some of you guys know in English, but I'm going to sing it in Spanish. I don't know if that's okay with you guys. It says, si tuvieras fe como un grano de mostaza, eso lo dice el Señor. And if I remember the translation, it says, if you had faith like a little mustard seed. I don't know if you've heard something like that. That's what the Lord says.
This is actually the very first time that I'm singing it in English, but I'm going to go back to Spanish.
Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Yeah.
It says like this.
Si tuvieras fe como un grano de mostaza, eso nos dice el Señor. Si tuvieras fe como un grano de mostaza, eso no dice el Señor. Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Y esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá. Si tuvieras fe como un grano de mostaza, eso no dice el Señor. Si tuvieras fe como un grano de mostaza, eso no dice el Señor. Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Y esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá. Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Y esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, y esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, se moverá, se moverá. Si tuvieras fe como un grano de mostaza, eso no dice el Señor. Si tuvieras fe como un grano de mostaza, eso no dice el Señor. Tú le dirías a la montaña, muévete, muévete. Tú le dirías a la montaña,
muévete. Everybody say muévete.
Muévete. Muévete.
Y esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, y esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá.
Esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, y esa montaña se moverá, esa montaña se moverá, y esa montaña se moverá, su montaña se moverá,
se moverá, se moverá.
I saw some of you guys. I saw some of you guys enjoying yourselves. You Puerto Rican, aren't you? Hallelujah. You know what I love about the presence of the Lord is that we can enjoy ourselves the way that David did. Now, David wasn't no stiff worshiper. He wasn't stiff, and you know, this is something that I know that my brother Nate, he's teaching his team, and let me tell you, your worship team is bonkers. I heard them practicing, and I'm like, I don't think I need to sing anything, because I love a church where there is a solid and healthy worship team, so let's give it up for the house worship team. I came with a plan. I came with a set list. And we're going to change it. I mean, some of these songs that we did have planned, but I after feeling the flow of this church, I do believe that we have to continue the flow and surrender and continue to acknowledge the kingship and the lordship of our Savior. And I believe that there is power when we sing his name. There is power when we call upon the name of Jesus. There is no other name that is greater, no other name that's more powerful than the name of Yeshua, the name of Jesus. Father, we exalt you in this place. We worship you, Jesus. Let's sing all together, my beloved is.
My beloved is the most beautiful among
Let's lift up our voices.
Say Yeshua.
Sing that again. Yours is a kingdom. It's the kingdom of yours. And every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is the King, that Jesus is the King. Hey. Oh, Jesus. There is healing and restoration. There is healing and restoration. There is healing and rest in His presence. There are people in this room who have not been able to rest. Because of anxiety, because of something that is worrying you, and I declare in the mighty and powerful name of Jesus, rest, rest, rest over your heart, rest over your emotions, rest in your mind, rest in your body, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Whatever it is that has you worried, whatever it is that is not allowing you to sleep, I declare the presence of the Almighty God, the presence of Yeshua that allows you to sleep, that allows you to rest in Him. And you need to know that everything is going to be all right. Everything is going to be all right. Everything's going to be all right. In the name of Jesus. Hey. You know, the enemy is going to try to shut you up. The enemy is going to try to silence your worship. I declare in the name of Jesus, breakthrough. I declare breakthrough. I declare boldness. Boldness. In the name of Jesus. And I declare that in the midst of your storm, in the midst of your problems, in the midst of your situation, you have the strength to shout, Yeshua, name above all names. The King of Kings is with me. The King of Kings is on my side. Yeah. 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 Hey, hey. There's an outpour of the presence of the Lord. There's an outpour of his spirit that's falling upon you tonight. That's falling upon you tonight. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. No weapon formed against you will prosper. No weapon formed against you will prosper. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I feel the need to remind you today that Jesus did not come to take you away from the issues and from the problems. Remember Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? They were faithful to God all the way. And they were threatened with their lives. And they said, it doesn't matter. I'm not going to turn my back on the Lord. And even still, they were thrown in the fire. They were thrown in the fire, but then they didn't see three men. They saw four men in that fiery furnace. Jesus is going to meet you at the point of your need. Jesus is going to meet you in your situation. He's going to meet you in your situation.
Powerful name, Yeshua. I will praise you in the middle of my storm. I will praise you in the midst of circumstances. Because my praise is a weapon. My praise is a weapon.
For those of you that are asking God why this and why that, you might not know right now why. And the tests that we go through are made for us to be stronger. You guys remember when you were in school and you had to take a test? And you remember when the teacher was not allowed to say anything to you? It's a test. And you need to trust and believe that all things are going to be okay. You're going to be okay. You're going to be okay. Just stay strong. Stay strong. I don't know why I'm saying this today, but I know some people need to hear that. I know some people need to know that God has all things under control. He has all things under control. You need to know that today. And I say this out of experience because I've been in a place where I had nowhere else to go and I had no more money. And we know how hard that is. Where you have nowhere else to run, nowhere else to turn to. And this is the hardest part, is when you continue to be faithful and things just seem to get worse and worse and worse and worse. I'm not going to get into my testimony. Another day I'll get into my testimony. But there's something that I've learned, is that God is faithful. And he comes on time. He shows up on time. I hope you remember that today. I hope you go home remembering that no matter what, he sees you, he hears you, and he's not forgotten you. He has not forgotten you. If you are in the midst of this test, of a test, don't give up on the Lord, because he's not giving up on you.
can sleep shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed shall prosper. It won't work. Oh, God will do what he said he would do. He will stand by his word. He will come through. Oh, God will do what he said he would do. He will stand by his word. He will come through. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against me. And I love you, Jesus, I love you. Yes, I love you, because you first loved me. Comes my way. Yes, I love you because you first loved, and nothing can tear me away from your love, Lord. Nothing can separate your heart from mine. Nothing can tear me away from your love, Lord. I am yours. I am yours. And nothing can tear me away from your love, Lord. Nothing can separate your heart from mine. Nothing can tear me away from. Come on, let's say, I am yours. I am yours. I Jesus, I love you. Oh, yes, I love you because you first loved me.
How easy it is to get caught up in moments like this and to sing so much and to say so much and shout that we forget to stay quiet. You know, he said, be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that he is God, that he has all things under control, and that he loves you. One of the simplest things that we hear all the time in church, Jesus loves you. I don't know if sometimes we forget how powerful those few words are. You imagine just walking right next to him and just him looking at you in the eyes with eyes of love, eyes of compassion. And you knowing what you're going through, you knowing what you did, what you said, what you thought about, whatever, and he is still there and he just says, I love you. And nothing will change that. The love of Jesus is so powerful, so powerful. Can we just give God some praise tonight for that? You guys all right? You guys good? You guys can sit down for just 2 seconds. Because we are not finished. So, like I mentioned a little bit earlier, one of my most amazing worship experiences was in Africa. And I learned a song, we learned a song, that I want to share with you guys. So you guys already sat down for a few seconds, that means you guys got to stand up already. All right, so, and it's okay if you want to sit down, it's okay. I know the music is going to get you up, don't worry. But I hope you like it. It says like this.
Hey, my God is good, oh. I've been my help from now till ever. My God is good, 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 my God is good unto you, my Lord. And I will shout and dance to you, for you have been my help another level.
So where? Glory to God.
Listen, how many, I'm going to let them, let's do this. Let's receive our giving, because y'all did the whole Soul Train line. So I'm going to let y'all forgive us. We're trying to get right with the Lord. We're just, you caused some of us to remember where we were. If you're blessed online watching, if you're in this sanctuary, we're going to do one or two more praise songs, or one. That's just extended. But can we honor the Lord with what God has blessed us to give? Y'all didn't sound convincing. Can we honor the Lord with what God has blessed us to give? Listen, I don't know where you are or what you're called to do, but I'm going to ask everyone in this room, even if you have to go, to put something in the ground. Whether you're watching online with us, maybe you can do 20, maybe you can do 25, maybe you can do 30, maybe you can do 40, maybe you can do 10, but I'm asking you to do something. You cannot ask God to multiply nothing from nothing. Let's give God something to multiply. Somebody say amen. Let's not ask God to put more in our hands without opening our hands. Does that make sense? So if you're watching online, y'all celebrating your house, I want you to join with us and give with us as we're giving. There are multiple ways to give. There's a new Cash App handle that's coming soon, just to make you aware. It's going to be TKC West or something like that. If you see it, it's not a fraudulent Cash App. It is ours. We're transitioning from the ones that we have so that you are aware and you're not intimidated by it. It's TKC Orlando West. That is another official Cash App. We're going to fade out TKC Orlando and TKC Orlando 1. So everyone in this room, let's give. I'm giving with you. As we honor the Lord, let me pray over our gifts. If you're doing it with me online, give me a fist bump online that I know that you're doing it with us. Let's pray. Father, this is an amazing time that we get to celebrate you, not just in word, but also in deed, in sacrifice. Would you bless that which we give? Would you multiply it and cause it to be used for the advancement of your house and your work and your cause? It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Ushers are coming to receive right in this moment. If you need an envelope, they should have given it to you. If you didn't get one, raise your hand. They can give one to you if you're not using the electronic way of giving. You can use an envelope. They're going to minister in song. A couple minutes, the ushers will come, receive, and we are good. Well, they're going to do one more praise song. I don't know. He looked like you have insurance, because it looked like you're going to tear the roof off of the church. All right. So they're going to do one more song. Ushers may receive at this time. They're going to lead you in one more selection, and then we're going to be blessed. Thank you so much for sowing. Thank you very much. Hopefully you are blessed tonight, and you are missed.
My brother, we're going to have, bring him up. I can't miss this moment. Okay. So we have the privilege of singing next to your worship team. So that's what I'm waiting for right now. Let's see what happens. Drums, go!
Come on, y'all, come to the altar. Come on, y'all.
Say,
let everything that I pray, praise the Lord.
In the valley, I praise on the mountain. I praise when I'm sure, and praise when I'm doubting. I praise in number, and I praise when surrounded. 'Cause praise in the water, my enemies drowning.
I know you guys know they sing.
As long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to pray.
Listen,
I praise when I feel it, and I praise when I don't.
cause I know you're still in control.
Come on, all together.
My praise is a weapon, more than a sound. My praise is the shout that brings Jericho down.
Say,
as long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord of my soul.
Somebody shout Jesus. Somebody shout.
that you met us here tonight. Let us not forget that your love is everlasting, that we trust in you, that we put our faith in you, that we put our trust in you, that everything that we do, that we will have you at the center of it all. So we thank you tonight as we leave this place, but never your presence. Let the name of Jesus be glorified, and no other name shall rise above that name, for he is Yeshua. And we thank you and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. And church, somebody make some noise. Y'all have a good night. I won't keep quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it?